Very good morning. This is an electrostatic precipitator filtration device used to filter smoke and dirt particles from flowing gas using electrostatic charges. As we all know, electrostatic precipitator is not something new in industrial sector. It has been there. But as we went to a survey on the industries around Jammu, we found that a lot of smoke was being produced by many industries like bricklaying, cement industry, iron and steel industries. So what we did, we went to the owners, we asked them that why weren't they using any sort of filtration devices. They said that they are very expensive and they have a very complex function. So based on that survey, we tried to figure out and design an electrostatic precipitator which was simple in its functioning, a very easily available and had, you know, that was very economical.
The best part about our electrostatic precipitator is that we have made this using the day-to-day things which we generally use in our homes. Like we have this metal scrub which we use to clean utensils in our home. We have this fan which gives a suction.
We have used wire mesh which is mostly used on the outer side of windows. So let me explain you the components of our electrostatic precipitator. First, we have here a PVC joint which acts as an inlet for smoke. Next, over here we have a fan which creates a suction inside the precipitator which pushes the smoke further into the unit. Over here we have used wire mesh as cathode which is connected to HVPS. Moving ahead, we have a case sort of structure made out of steel wool. We have applied wire mesh around it. It is the anode, the positive terminal. This is the outlet through which the smoke comes out. This whole of the structure has been enclosed in between a glass tube made out of borosil, which can withstand large amounts of temperature and pressure.
What happens is, the polluted air enters this electrostatic precipitator unit through this inlet. Further, there is a fan which produces a suction which pushes the polluted air further in the unit. Next, we have this cathode which is connected to this high voltage power supply which produces a high voltage of 15 to 35 kV which is sufficient enough to ionize the molecules in air, especially the pollutants. After a significant distance, we have connected an anode. So what happens is the charged particles, the negatively charged particles get attracted towards the walls of the positively charged particles. And the air does not get ionized and it passes through the unit.
So the air that comes out is ozone. It is not very good for direct breathing. However, it is very beneficial for our environment as it prevents ultraviolet rays of sun from entering the atmosphere. Moreover, we can dissolve this O3 into water which will make it break down into O2 and O, which are very useful components as well. Thank you.